All right, so for this example of comprehensive information processing, you see this person has come to a new GitHub README and they're taking their time reading through all of the information on this page. They're checking out this part about dependencies and whatnot, and you know, they're just going along, taking their time, making sure they gather all the information they need. They see this command, they know that they're gonna need it later, but they keep moving on and make sure that they gather all the information before getting started. Selective information processing, on the other hand, is a little bit more speedy. They're reading through and then they see this command right here and they figure, I might as well try it right now. So they go ahead and run the command right away. So for learning styles, process-oriented learners tend to want to follow a process. So this person is on a new GitHub README and they want to create a new branch. So they Google search how to create a new branch with Git and they find this web page that seems like it'll have a useful tutorial for them. So they, you know, read through the tutorial. It's got some figures on like what's actually going on. It has a command for them to use, a couple different commands, and an example of what the command actually means, and a figure that shows them what's actually going on in Git when they do this. So then they see that those top two commands are the most important for them. And so now they can go over and actually run the command and complete their task. And it takes a second, but then this person ends up creating a new branch, which is what they want. Now for tinkerers, this process is a little bit different. Instead of going and looking up a tutorial, this person thinks, okay, well, I know a couple different commands in Git, so I'm just gonna try a couple different things out. So they tried out Git branch and it told them the names of the branches, but that didn't quite seem right. So now they try a couple different things to see, okay, and so now they've tried Git branch and then adding a name on and then doing it again, and they can see that the branch they wanted to make is on there in their list. So now they just have to tinker to figure out which command will take them actually over to that branch. So they try one thing, doesn't quite work, but they think, oh, this seems like it's pretty close. And voila, now they have also completed their task as well.